Hey guys, this video will be totally in English because most of the people from the southern region are not able to understand Hindi. So in this video, we will be talking about the marks versus rank you will receive in VIT examination. I will be talking about all the ranks required for all the categories 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not much talking about the 4th and 5th category because it's just like a management quota. You can even get admission even if you don't score 10 marks. But I will be telling you thoroughly about the category 1 and category 2. All the marks required. And what rank you will receive on what marks. So without any further ado, let's start with the video. As we know, the exam was preponed and this time the total marks were 80 marks. But the main concern was you were given only 90 minutes for 80 questions. So it was bit difficult for the students. And the second part was students were not allowed to skip the question. They were given a 40 seconds timer. So if the student wants to skip the question, he won't be able to till 40 seconds. So it's just like a time waste. I don't know why they did that. So now straight away marks versus rank. So you have to basically understand that this time you have to score more marks with respect to the previous years, because this time as the examination was conducted online, the students have used various means to write their paper, and by various means, you know what I want to say. So marks versus rank for category 1. For 75 plus marks, you will get a rank under 100. For 70 plus, you will get 500. For 65 plus, your rank will be under 1000. For 60 plus, you will be under 3000. For 55 plus, you will be under 4500. For 50 plus, you will be under 7500. For 45 plus, you will get a rank under 10,000. And for 35 plus, you will get a rank under 20,000. Not going into the numbers and telling you roughly how much marks you need for category 1 for a reputed branch. It will be 60 marks out of 80 at least. See, as the marks go down, there won't be a huge variation between some ranks. Because when you reach an average marks, there are many students lying on the same criteria. So there won't be any huge effect on your rank. As such, the VIT Valor administration has never given a cutoff for the examination, or they haven't disclosed ever the marks versus rank criteria. Now these marks versus rank can vary because it's not a solid data. The VIT administration hasn't provided any data yet, like for how much marks they give what rank, and none of the YouTubers can give you a solid data. But I have analyzed a trend of 10 years and then concluded these marks versus cutoff, and so you can rely on it. There might be a difference of 5 to 6 marks. So talking about the re-examination, the students have made a plea to the VIT administration that the examination should be retaken because there was a heavy cheating recorded, and so it is an online based paper, and if we consider that there will be no re-examination, the results must be out till 6th of June to 8th of June. Because it is an online protected examination, there won't be a much delay. So the main fight is for the category 1 and category 2, and if you need a reputed branch in category 1 and category 2, so you need to score more than 55 plus.